What is an MS4? Pennsylvania is a water-rich state with many high-quality streams, but we know from field studies that many waterways suffer from polluted stormwater runoff. Water bodies in cities and suburbs are particularly vulnerable to stormwater because these landscapes contain large areas covered by hard surfaces like roads, parking lots, and rooftops designed to drain stormwater quickly without allowing it to soak into the ground. The MS4 program was created to help manage and clean up stormwater in these urban parts of the state. MS4 is short for Municipal Separate Storm Sewer System, where municipal refers to a local unit of government, like a borough or a township that contains developed areas, and the number 4 refers to the 4 words that start with the letter S, Separate Storm Sewer System. A separate storm sewer system is a collection of structures designed to gather stormwater from built-up areas and discharge it without treatment into local streams and rivers. It's called a separate system because it's not connected to the sanitary sewer system, which drains wastewater from inside a home to a sewage treatment facility or a private septic system. Some communities in Pennsylvania do have combined storm and sanitary sewers. The areas served by these combined systems are not covered by the MS4 program. Many rural developments have stormwater management structures, but only communities that the U.S. Census Bureau classifies as an urbanized area based on a population density that's high enough are required to become part of the MS4 program. Urbanized areas contain plenty of commercial and residential development, which produces large amounts of stormwater runoff. Large, independently managed institutions, like the Penn State campus and State College shown here, are also part of the MS4 program because they also contain the type of dense development that produces concentrated stormwater flows. And in case you are wondering, PennDOT and the Turnpike Commission are also part of the MS4 program because of the many separate storm sewer systems they build and maintain along roadways. Communities have been installing and repairing separate storm sewer systems, like the flood-damaged pipes in this image, for a very long time, but the MS4 program is relatively new. Pennsylvania's first two MS4s were Pittsburgh and Philadelphia, which have been in the program since the 1990s. The state's remaining MS4s, around 950 of them, started joining in the early 2000s. The program is managed by the Pennsylvania Department of Environmental Protection, or DEP, which fulfills this role to comply with national mandates under the Clean Water Act. The Environmental Protection Agency has a role because they are the federal agency charged with implementing the Clean Water Act. MS4 communities get a permit from DEP that has a very long official name. It's called an NPDES permit, which stands for National Pollution Discharge Elimination System. The word national references the connection with the National Clean Water Act, and the word discharge refers to the fact that separate storm sewer systems eventually release stormwater into local creeks, rivers, and lakes untreated. The permits are also called MS4 permits or just stormwater permits. To meet the terms of their MS4 permit, communities need to develop what's called an SWMP, or Stormwater Management Program. Communities that discharge stormwater into the Chesapeake Bay watershed or into what DEP calls an impaired waterway are also required to take additional steps, but this video will only cover the basic requirements that apply to all MS4 communities. Every community's stormwater management program is unique, but they are all based on the same 6 MCMs, or minimal control measures. The first MCM is public education and outreach. The goal here is educating residents about local stormwater issues. To achieve this requirement, communities develop a plan for informing residents about stormwater management. Common activities include creating municipal web pages, informational flyers and brochures, and providing presentations at schools and community events. The next MCM is public participation and involvement. The goal here is getting residents involved in stormwater reduction activities. Examples include rain garden workshops, community stream cleanups, or public meetings where residents can help shape the overall MS4 program. The next MCM is illicit discharge detection and elimination. The goal here is keeping pollutants out of the separate storm sewer system, which happens when things other than stormwater get dumped into a storm sewer inlet, and also happens when storm sewers and sanitary sewers are illegally connected. Examples of illicit substances include septic tank drainage, laundry wash water, paint, automobile oil, and grease from restaurant grease traps. Remember, what goes down the storm sewer eventually ends up in a local stream, river, or lake without treatment. The next MCM is construction site erosion control. Poorly managed construction sites can be a major source of polluted stormwater, so MS4s are required to reduce this risk. Activities include procedures to make sure erosion and sediment control practices, like the filter sock and silt fence pictured here, are installed correctly and maintained as long as needed. The next MCM is post-construction stormwater management. Its goal is making sure new buildings, parking lots, and other developments don't create future stormwater headaches. Typical activities include installing structures like the infiltration basin shown here, which captures runoff from an adjacent parking lot. The final minimal control measure is pollution prevention and good housekeeping. This MCM requires reducing stormwater pollution from the maintenance yards, streets, parking lots, buildings, and other facilities owned by the MS4 permit holder. It also includes upkeep of the separate storm sewer system itself. Pennsylvania contains thousands of miles of beautiful, high-quality creeks and rivers, but 300 years of development have left a lasting mark on many others. It won't happen overnight, but the MS4 program was created to prevent new damage to the water quality in these streams and help heal past scars.